where did you come from? I said, where did you come from? Who sent you?
Yeah. That seems to be his problem.
He hurt his ankle.
Expect me to hold him up?
Now look, this man is hurt.
I need him to be a lot worse than that if you don't cooperate. Now get up. I said get up and stay up. Now what's your name?
Smokey the Bear.
Track mine, but every time a bullseye.
Hey! I saw it! I saw it with my own eyes. Yes, sir. Outstanding. He hit that target right there, right in the center. That was the slickest, smoothest, most outstanding piece of marksmanship I have ever seen. Yes, sir. Our boys are all primed and ready for some duck hunting. No more flying! We're going to do nothing until the next practice session in January except have fun, fun, fun!
I knew it. He's going to get married.
Now, just wait a minute. You can say anything you want to about me except that. All right? All right, I'll give it to you straight. No dramatics. Just the way I heard it happen. You ready? I'm going around the corner. Coming to the boss's office, when I hear him say on the telephone, T-A-D. Huh? Now, we all know what T-A-D means, don't we? What does it mean?
Temporary additional duty.
Right. T-A-D. And for whom? For we three. We three, who only want to fish and swim and water ski and fly an airplane. Where do you think we're going? Come on, ask me. Where are we going?
Where are we going?
I'll tell you. We are going to the most beautiful, wonderful, I can't, spot in America, El Centro! You know what we're going there for? Desert survival training.
You're kidding, Hank. There goes a deposit on that hunting lodge.
Deposit? Deposit? Scotty, old boy, remember that little bathing beauty, Becky Steiner? Well, she's coming over from Jacksonville for the weekend. Now, I've been waiting for this kid for 6 months. Now, let's get the boss to change his mind, huh? Come on. Listen, where'd you comp that thing anyway?
Right, Chief. No sweat. Well, three guys I was thinking about. Something we can do for you, Counselor.
Yes.
I want to talk to you about
our hunting trip.
Well, it's all set, the deposits on the lodge.
No. About the amount of ammunition we're going to take on the hunting trip.
What's with the price, eh?
Oh. Nice. You know, boss, we had a pretty good year. We've racked up 78 shows. We got a TV show going for us, and worked out some of the kinks, but makes a man really feel good. Gosh darn it, really makes a man feel good. You know, the other day, I was reading one of those outdoor health-type magazines. You know, during the coffee break, of course, and old Hank never reads on the job. Well, anyway, in this magazine, there was an advertisement, see? It showed one of these real strong outdoor men, you know, he's posing there, and it said that, and he had a dog, see, and he was puffing on his pipe.
very happy, petting a dog and all. There was a caption on it, and the caption said, "A man works harder when he can relax with his two best friends, his dog and his pipe."
Where's the dog?
Oh, well, you see, I wanted to see it this weekend.
What's the dog's name?
Becky Steiner. Becky Steiner?
That's a pretty good try, Hank. You know, I got a feeling you guys already know what I'm going to say.
You changed your mind?
Changed it? No, I just made it up a short time ago. I decided that we really ought to take advantage of the next few weeks we have before we start next year's shows. So our first deal is going to be, of course, in desert survival training. I've been through it. You guys have.
The desert. By golly, that sounds like a good idea. Yes, sir. The wide open spaces, mountains, air. Challenge to any Marine.
Yes, sir. Jackrabbits, rattlesnakes, lizards.
Buzzards, ants.
Boys, we have been had. H-A-D had, but we love L-O-V-E, love you very, very much.
Take off from operations at 1800. You'll pick up a flight on a P-2V that's returning to Los Alamos. Pack light. Bring along an old flight suit for the desert. Your contact there is Commander Robert Mills. Good guy. That's all.
Becky Steiner?
Huh?
You couldn't call a dog Sam. You couldn't call him Meredith. You couldn't call him Don. You couldn't call him Becky Steiner.
The only food you will have is what you kill or gather. You'll be equipped with fatigue suits and hats, field shoes, knife, a sidearm, one canteen of water, a wristwatch, and a compass. Now, you must memorize the directions on this chart, plus the various landmarks. Study it hard. And when you think you have it made, restudy it. Details get a little hazy out there when the sand and the sun start to work on you. Your first leg will take you to this dry gulch. This point right here. Okay? All set? Good luck.
I remember the first leg is 035 for 12 hours.
Any objections?
You know, it's times like this, I wish I were a warrior instead of a lover.
Save the talk for tonight. We'll need it.
Great idea for support.
Yeah. We'll be a little colder tonight with these backs torn out of the jackets, but that'll be all right.
Okay, come on, let's go.
Hey, come here. Oh, easy. There you go. Put your arm around.
Okay. Now we have that.
Okay.
All right, Tom.
There's a hole.
Hey. What's your whistle? Hank, I think you found a friend. Yeah. They look like some of the bums who used to hang around my neighborhood in Brooklyn.
the only goof off, Scotty. Ouch. Meet your brother-in-law.
Now there's about a third left. Could have been worse. He loves me.
Ooh.
He loves me not. Becky, a great big bite.
Next leg from this water hole is 145 degrees.
Right.
Scotty said 165.
How about it, Scotty?
145.
All right, all right.
As they used during the World War. It's abandoned.
Hank?
I don't
remember the briefing officer saying anything about a abandoned airstrip. You think we're lost?
I told you. 165.
It was 145.
Oh, don't give me that stuff. You always think you're right, Mac. Always right. 165.
It was 145.
No.
Back to Scotty and open it up, huh?
Find out a few things, and the sooner we do, the better. supposed to be a condenser with that. All right, which one of you took it?
Drop dead, Lars.
Oh, you've got a big mouth, don't you? All right, which one of you took it?
I did.
I did.
Me too. You know, Corporal.
Yeah. That devil threw you of a bad man. Inside. Hold it. Your flashlight. All right, up. Up, all the way up. What did you do with that condenser?
I said, what did you do with that condenser?
Please.
I have no cigarettes to waste on traps.
Look, I got a pipe, see? Pipe. I got some tobacco. I need a match.
All right. Up.
Be quick about it. Attached to the survival school. The boss is coming here in a plane any minute now to see how we're doing.
You're doing just great. The only boss you got is the guy that dropped that gear over the border. So you could set up a monitoring deal somewhere in the States, huh?
I'm telling you, it's just a frame.
Shut up, or I'll cut you to this. Easy. Up. I told you, shut up! Oh, you knew when I got you in trouble. Shut up!
Somebody's shooting.
I'm glad my boys are firing blanks.
Hey, Mac, Scotty, it's the boss. Jackson, Abram, this is Mel. Boss!
It's Hank. He sounds like a very mad Italian. Hank, it's the boss!
Hey, boss, look what I found.
Commander, those were a couple of fine boys you had. They really had us going for a while.
Yeah, Abram was Jackson. Two of my very best men.
Yeah, Skipper, how come you were so tough on us?
Tell him, Bob.
This is my idea, Scotty. I wanted to test a new type of special exercise. It's really an exercise in the military code of conduct. And to be effective, the treatment has to be real.
Real? That was so real, it was tough.
You're right, that exercise was tough. It was meant to be tough. But remember what we're trying to do. We're trying to teach our fighting men that they follow in big footsteps. And now I'm talking about every true American fighting man in every war we fought. From the Revolution right down through Korea. Every lonesome, cold, miserable, sick guy who was there to be counted when the chips were down. Every guy who gritted at the pain, blood, and the misery, and then spit right in the enemy's eye. Said, come on, mister, try me. These are the men who really wrote the military code of conduct. Unless we can make certain the fighting man of today and tomorrow will also be there to be counted when everything has gone but guts, then we've let that long line of brave men down. Perhaps too many Americans take this way of life for granted. This way of life that was paid for by those who were willing to go for broke. Willing to make that ultimate sacrifice. Maybe we're getting soft. Well, if we are, then it's time to get going and do something about it. You know, today there are no physical frontiers by which a man may test what's inside. Today, a fighting man must rely on the training he's had. Then he has to reach down into his beliefs, into his country's history. And when he looks in his hand, he's got to find that core of valor that makes a man a hero when he faces death alone. Makes him climb to his feet and wipe the blood out of his eyes and yell at the enemy, come on, Mac, try me.
You know something, Commander? I'm sorry, I apologize to those two good eyes. I'm sure Scotty and Mac feel the same way. And I'll tell you something else. I'm glad I did what I did to them. But one of those two guys owes me a new pipe.
Here, Hank, break this in to Miss Becky Steiner. Private game.
Becky Steiner?
This has been a Galoo production in association with California National Production.
Most outstanding piece of marksmanship I have ever seen. You
Yes, sir. Our boys are all primed and ready for some duck hunting. No more flying. We're going to do nothing until the next practice session in January except have fun, fun, fun.
I knew it. He's going to get married.
Now, just wait a minute. You can say anything you want to about me except that. All right? All right, I'll give it to you straight. No dramatics, just the way I heard it happen. You ready? I'm going around the corner, coming to the boss's office.
Track mine, but every time a bullseye.
Hey! I saw it! I saw it with my own eyes. Yes, sir. Outstanding. He hit that target right there, right in the center. That was the slickest, smoothest. When I hear him say on the telephone, T-A-D. Huh? Now, we all know what T-A-D means, don't we? What does it mean?
Temporary additional duty.
Right. T-A-D. And for whom? For we three. We three, who only want to fish and swim and water ski and fly an airplane. Where do you think we're going? Come on, ask me. Where are we going?
Where are we going?
I'll tell you. We are going to the most beautiful, wonderful... I can't spot in America.
I said, where did you come from?
Who sent you?
Who sent you?
Yeah. That seems to be his problem.
He hurt his ankle.
Expect me to hold him up?
Now look, this man is hurt.
I can see him.
It's worse than that if you don't cooperate. Now get up.
Get up and stay up. Now, what's your name?
Smokey the Bear.